Okay, so good morning, students. So we'll start with the today's lecture. In today's lecture, we have discussed about the basics of the Earth, then the Sun, and main thing we have discussed about the how the energy is generated inside the Sun and how that is radiated or that comes to the Earth surface. Okay. So we also discuss about the different the zones of the Sun. The core is the main, that is the center, the region of the Sun, that is what are the core. After that we have the radiative zone, then convective, then photosphere, then we have chromosphere, and lastly or the last part is the transition region. After this transition region we have the corona, and then after corona then the solar radiation, it comes to the Earth surface. Okay, so we have seen how this greenhouse the gases are formed. That is formed because of the combination of two things. One is the crust and the mantle, and because of through these two things, that is called the lithosphere, the porous layer of this the greenhouse gas is formed, and we call that as the atmosphere. Everything which is near to the Earth surface, that is called the terrestrial region, and one which is away from that the Earth surface or the above the atmosphere, that is called the extraterrestrial region. Okay, then we have seen how the sun rays or the solar radiation, it comes to the Earth surface. So there are three types of the radiation. One which directly comes to the Earth surface, we call that as the beam radiation or the direct radiation. The others may get deflected because of the some deflection, or we call that as a diffuse radiation. So it may be cloud, it may be the soil. Okay, so that is because that comes because of the and after reflection, when it comes to the Earth surface, we call that as a diffuse radiation. Okay, and one which is the reflected back. Okay, so the radiations, the amount of radiation which get reflected back. Okay, so because of the soil plantation on the Earth, so we call that as a albedo. Okay, so these are the three things. Now we have three things in with us. One is called the beam radiation, which is directly coming on the Earth surface. Diffuse radiation, which get the radiation which is coming to the Earth surface, but by means of the deflection or the scattering, reflection or the scattering, so we call it as a diffuse radiation. And if we combine these two, beam plus diffuse, so that is called as the global radiation. Now we have some instruments for measurements of this radiations now. Okay, so we will see what are these three different types of what are the instruments which are used for the measurements of these radiations. Okay, so that is our today's topic. Okay, so the first instrument is the pyranometer. So pyranometer is used for the measurements of the global radiation. So global means it is the combination of beam plus diffuse radiation. Okay, so it is on the usually on the horizontal surface, but we can also tilt it or we can also fit it on the inclined surface. Okay, so that is the thing. Now this is used for the measurement of the global radiation. So we'll first see what is this, how it works, then we'll discuss this thing, the next thing. Okay, so pyranometer, first of all, it is used for the measurements of the global radiation, so the beam plus diffuse radiation. Now this is the block diagram for the pyranometer. Now how it works, so it combines of the two glass dome. One is the outer glass dome and the other is the inner glass dome. So it is placed at 180 degrees. So this is the semicircular space, and semicircular that arc is there of glass, and the radiations will come through. Okay, so this radiation can come in these directions. Okay, so all these directions, so it can take the 180 degree. So this is something like this. So okay, so radiations are coming like this. Okay, now it is having the outer glass dome plus the inner glass dome. Okay, so combination of domes means to just to prevent the instrument from the dust and the rain. So that is the main applications of this, the glass dome. Plus it also allows the entry of the sun rays, and that sun rays then enters into the sensing element. We call this as a sensing element. It is black in shape so that it can absorb the maximum radiation. Okay, or all the radiation. So that is called the, that is our sensing element. Now the sensing element is having, it is just act as a the thermocouple. It is having one hot junction, and this one is the bottom side. It is having the, it is a cold junction. Okay, so when the upper part get heated because of the absorption of the solar radiation which is coming from the sun, and the bottom part or that is remain cold because it is not exposed to the sun, the solar radiation, so it is remains cold. And because of these two, there is a generation of the potential difference, and the current is developed. Okay, so and when this current is measured, and then it is converted using the conversion factor, then it is converted into watt per meter square. Okay, so incident solar radiation, it is calculated in terms of this watt per meter square. Okay, so that is the simple working of this the pyranometer. So here also it is shown, this is that sensing we call that as a thermopile. Okay, so this is just the extension of your thermocouple. Okay, so this is the black surface which absorb the incident solar radiation, and the bottom surface, okay, of that thermopile, it is taken as the reference reference surface or reference thermopile. Okay, so and because of the potential difference between these two, there is a generation of the electric current, and then that current it is converted into that electric current it is measured, and using the conversion factor it is then converted into the watt per meter square. Okay, so solar energy incident per unit area. Okay, so that is calculated. Okay, the another parts we have desiccant here to keep it dry, then we have some the adjustable the screws and the adjustable feet is there, so just to adjust the this instrument. Okay, so the instrument looks like something like this. So this is the pyranometer. Okay, so these are the two glass dome, and then we have that black surface at the somewhat here. Okay, so this is our the black surface. Okay, see here. And this is our leveling screws. Okay, that's there. Okay, now it gives directly the what we are getting here, the global radiations. Now we know that the global radiation, it consists of what? The beam radiation, that is mean the direct radiation, plus it consists of what? It is consists of the diffuse radiation. Okay, so now suppose we only want to measure the diffuse radiation, so that means we have to now restrict or we have to block this beam radiation. Now how to block this beam radiation? We know that the beam radiation means which are coming directly from the sun, okay, or it is coming directly to the to that particular instrument. So that means we have to block this beam radiation. So for to block this beam radiation, so we are using here one shield. Okay, so shading ring we are using here. So this is shading ring. So if you place the shading ring above this glass dome here, so this is the shading ring, so that will block the beam radiation, so which are directly coming on this this glass surface, okay, or the glass dome. Okay, and the other radiations will come, or it will enter into this pyranometer by means of the reflections or the scattering. Okay, so we call that as a diffuse radiations. Okay, so whenever you have to measure only the diffuse radiation, so just block the beam radiation using this shading ring. Okay, so this shading ring which is placed, if it is placed over the pyranometer, then it measures on the diffuse radiation, and if this shading ring is not there, then we get both the radiation, that is the beam plus diffuse radiation, and then in that case the pyranometer will measure the global radiation. Okay, so for both the purpose this pyranometer is used, for the measurement of the global radiation and for the measurement of the diffuse radiation. The condition is only that whenever you are going to measure the diffuse radiation, the diffuse radiation, just block this beam radiation using what? The shading ring. Okay, so that is the function of the pyranometer. Okay, yes. Now the next thing is it is then pyranometer. Now we are discussing about we have beam, we have diffuse, and we have global. So beam plus diffuse we have seen, pyranometer we have used for this one. We have measured the diffuse also, and we have measured together as a global also. Now beam is remaining. So how to measure only the beam radiation? So for on measuring the beam radiation only here. Okay, so for measuring only the beam radiations, we are using the instrument that is called as the pyranometer. Okay, so that an instrument that measures beam radiation by using a long and narrow tube. to collect only beam radiation from the sun at normal incidence. So that is our pyranometer. Okay, so it is just similar to the telescope, something like this. Okay, solar radiation comes directly from this lens. Okay, and so here this is there. So this is our this glass, that hollow tube. Okay, we have here the lens here. So this is the lens. Okay, here this is the lens. This is our tube, hollow tube. Okay, and the sun rays, it enters into this globe by using some the angle. We call this as the acceptance angle. So this acceptance angle must be 5 degrees, and this is adjusted using the alignment indicator and this two-axis tracking system. Okay, so the angle must be, the angle must be kept within this range. That means the acceptance angle is what, 5 degrees only. Okay, and when this the solar radiation, it enters into through this lens, so that lens convert that into the lens reflect that solar radiations on the, again see here the same principle is there. We have the black absorber plate. So this black absorber plate, it is having two surfaces. One is on the top surface, another on the bottom. So that black surface, it absorbs the solar radiation which is coming from the sun, and it gets heated. So one on the top end, we have the hot surface, and the bottom end of that plate, it is remain that means it is cold, and it is not exposed to the sun rays, so it remain cold. So we have now the two things, one is the hot junction and another is the cold junction, and because of this there is generation of EMF, electric current is generated, and then that the current is measured. Okay, and then using the conversion factor, the amount of the beam radiation which falls on this black surface, it is calculated in terms of what, the watt per meter square. Okay, so that is the, again, the simple working of pyroelio meter. Okay, so this is the working. So here only main thing is what, in pyranometer we are using we are measuring beam plus diffuse radiation. Okay, so if it is open, if you are using the shading ring, then we can measure here diffuse radiation only. And in pyranometer, we are using what, we are measuring here only the beam radiation or the direct radiation. So this is used for measuring the pyranometer. Okay, so these are your gate question also. They generally ask in the gate examination also. Okay, so this is the working of your pyranometer. Okay, now what is this, just see the comparison between these two. We have just seen here now so this is your sun. Okay, now this is your this is your direct radiation, so this is your beam radiation. Now if this is get scattered or reflected, and then it is coming on the earth surface, so then it is, this is what, your diffuse radiation. So both the radiations, so these are falling on your this black surface, and using this thermopile they are converting that radiations in terms of the watt per meter square. Okay, so in terms of the current, the using the conversion factor, we are converting that one. So it used was beam plus diffuse. If you block this one, if you block this beam radiation, then you can measure only this diffuse radiation here. On the other side, okay, this is your pyranometer, and on the other side, the sun, the direct radiation that is coming, that is entering into the pyranometer. Okay, and we are measuring here what, we are measuring only here the beam radiation. Okay, within the acceptance angle of 5 degrees. Okay, so that is there. So this is the comparison, this speaker showed the comparison between these two things. Okay, pyranometer and the pyranometer. Okay, now the last one now. Okay, the last thing is the sunshine recorder. Okay, now sunshine recorder. Now the sunshine recorder, it consists of one the glass sphere. Okay, and then it is having one the hemispherical or the dome, something like this. Okay, and then it is having what? It is having some the measuring paper. Okay, it is having the measuring paper, and then when the solar radiation, it comes, it falls on this one, so we'll get the duration of the sunshine hours in a day. So it measures what? It measures this, the sunshine hours in a day. Okay, so it is having one glass sphere, one the this semicircular dome, and then on that we have some measuring paper. Okay, so how it works then, we'll see this one. Now what happens here, we have the glass sphere which concentrate the rays. Now when the sunlight falls on this day falls on this glass dome, so the glass sphere concentrate the rays of the sun and focuses onto the strip of the paper. Okay, so first of all it is the this part, okay, this one which is holding this glass sphere. So this this is adjusted. Okay, so as the sun rays travels across the sky, the rays are pointed toward a different section of the we have to get that thing. So first of all it is adjusted, it is first you have to adjust it toward the north. Okay, so you have to put towards the north direction like this. Then what happens here, so the glass sphere concentrate the rays and then it falls on this strip of the paper. Now there are three we are using here a strip of the paper. Okay, now this strip consists of we have three types of the paper. Okay, so one if it is a summer, then you have to use this type of paper. Okay, and if it is winter, then it is this type of the paper. Okay, so like this. Okay, and if it is in between, so then we have to use this one, this paper. So we have three types of the paper for summer, winter and the equinox. Okay, so accordingly you have to use the paper. So if you see this the paper, on that paper the date is mentioned. That means this paper you can use that means particular paper you can use from in the summer the months, and which paper you are using for the winter month. So this can be differentiated by just seeing the backside of this paper, and on that backside paper, on the backside of this paper, the date is mentioned. Okay, so that is there. Now this paper, suppose we will consider it is a summer, and then you have to put that paper here, strip of paper in the slot here. Okay, now when the sun rays it falls on the glass sphere, then it concentrate the sun rays, it get concentrated and then it falls on the paper. Okay, and then it forms the burning marks. It forms the burning marks on this paper. Okay, so the burning marks are formed. So whenever the sun travels, suppose the sun is traveling from suppose this direction, so we'll get the burning mark something like this here, like this here, and then it goes something like this. Okay, now each division, so if you see here then in this diagram, okay, so so if you see here the paper, so here you will see the burning marks. Now here each division, so this division, so this is for 1 hour, this is for 1 hour, and it starts from 6 a.m. okay, so it starts from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. okay, so 6 7 8 9 10 11 12, so here we have 12, then 1 2 3 4 5 6, something like this. Okay, so 6 a.m. to 6:12, here 12 noon, and then from 12 noon to again 6 p.m. okay, and if you put this sunshine recorder towards the north, and you will see the burning marks here. Now you see here the burning marks or here also, so you have to count the number of the hours. So here, see here, this is 1 hour, this is suppose 2 hour, then this is 3 4 5 6 and 7, something like this. Okay, this is not counted half and half, it is counted as one. So total how many hours? So 7 hours. Okay, so that means the sunshine hours, as it is calculated as 7 hours. Okay, now let me show you this one. Now this is the sunshine recorder which you use for the measuring of this is sunshine hours in a day. Okay, that is calculated. Now this the particular thing. Now this is taken from one the famous instrument, so that I am going to show you now. So you might be heard of these things. Let me take you there to that one. So okay, so you might be heard of these things. Okay, so this is the famous the place in our India. So we call this as a Jantar Mantar. Okay. Now, if you carefully see here, okay, so this one. So this is the this is that particular that it is this is called as the, that particular sunshine recorder. It is developed from this instrument. Okay, and this is developed years ago. Okay, now here there is a wall. Okay, so if you see from this one, this is called as the Virat Yantra. It is known as the Virat Yantra, and here there is one wall. Okay, vertical wall. And then similar to that semicircular the dome, we have that strip is placed here. Okay, so this is that particular strip. Now whenever the sun comes here, okay, so whenever we have the sun, so we have two parts. One is from here 6 to 12, and then from this part is what 12 to 6. Okay, so the shadow of this wall, it falls on this particular dome. Okay, and using that particular shadow, we can measure the time of the particular day. Okay, so that can be measured. Okay, so how it measures, so it is, that is also shown in some in one of the video. Let me show you if you can see that one. Let me show you the another one.
From the very first White Hat Junior trial class, Saira was hooked.
Okay, same thing is coming. Yes, yeah. So yeah. So this is called as Virat Samrat Yantra. Okay. So this is considered as the biggest the sun clock in the world. Okay. Now how it works? So that is given here. So this is the that construction. Okay. We have the vertical wall. And then we have that semicircular dome. Now see this one, this is the shadow. The sun shadow is moving on this thing, and here the marking is there. Okay, so each this division, so this represents 1 hour, and here also there are the divisions. Okay, so this 1 hour, now then again it is divided into the 60 minutes. Okay, so and then it is having the accuracy of 2 seconds. Okay, so every 2 seconds it moves. So and then it is divided into eastern and the western parts. So this is eastern part, this is the western part. So one I already told you, so this is 6 to 12 a.m. so that is that part is here, and the remaining part is from the 12 to 6 p.m. so that is in the evening. Okay, so 12 to 6. Now what happens when the sun it travels? So the shadow the wall shadow, it falls on the semicircular dome, and then using that thing we can measure the time of the day. Okay, so here there are various instruments that is present in this Jantar Mantar, which is related with our the solar. It depends on the solar energy. Okay, so these things are also there. This is the again the clock. This clock is for 24 hours. Okay, we have seen this the Virat Yantra, this is for only 12 hours, but if you want to count the that means in the night also, so we have the this is the clock. So it works on here. There are two clocks. One is on the right hand side, another is on the left hand side. So this is northern hemisphere, and this is the southern hemisphere. So these clocks are used six months and 6 months. Okay, so these are used for the measurements of the time for the 24 hours. Okay, so this is for 24 hours, and this Virat Yantra is for the 12 hours. Okay, so that is there. Okay, so there are different things here. So this is Okay, for measurements of the celestial attitude and everything, so that are present here. So this is all regarding the measurements of the solar radiation. Okay, and that is one of the questions that was asked in our the previous examination. So what are the different types of the solar radiation? So first of all, you have to write down the definitions for the solar radiations: beam radiation, diffuse radiation, and the global radiation, and explain the any two measuring instruments for the any two instruments which are used for measurements of the solar radiation. So either you can explain this pyranometer, or particularly they will ask explain the construction and working of the pyranometer, pyrolometer, or sunshine recorder. Okay, so this is regarding the measurements of the solar radiations. Okay, now this is all regarding the this measuring instruments, and in next theory class, then we will deal with now the another important topic. So that is the solar geometry then. Okay, and this is very important topic, solar geometry. Okay, and here the solar geometry, it deals with the various types of the angles. Okay, and then we have some numericals also based on this solar geometry. Okay, so we'll see what are the different types of the solar geometry in our next lecture, and we'll try to solve one or two the numericals based on this solar geometry. Okay, so this is all regarding the today's lecture. So if you have any difficulty regarding the today's lecture, you can ask, or otherwise we will stop here, and in tomorrow's lecture we will discuss the solar geometry. I have keep this. I'm not starting the solar geometry. We'll start with this solar geometry, and we'll take in a complete one lecture. Okay. Okay. So this is from my side for the today's lecture. So which is related with the measurements of the solar radiation. Okay. So thank you very much. If you are having any questions, you can ask. Otherwise, we will stop here.
Hello, sir.
Ha.